Okay, we're going to replace the keyboard on this HP Pavilion 15, almost 10 years old. Really doesn't work anymore, so we're just going to get it out of there. Replace it now. Okay, now the first thing you have to do with this HP is to take out this one screw here, and you can see there's a little tiny keyboard. You'll have to look, because that's what's holding down the keyboard on the front here. So that screwdriver, that screw has to come out. And I'm using a number one Phillips to do that. Okay, that was simple enough. Oh, it didn't want to stick that time. Okay. There we go. Okay, put it down here. Now, you can actually, if you wanted to, you could use something like this to push the keyboard so you can see it come up, and then use a spudger tool. But what I'm going to do here is, I think it's a little simpler. I'm going to just take the number four slot here and put it in here and just get it out this way. In this particular case, the keyboard doesn't work, and I just got to get it out. I got to find a place where it wants to give way. Found one. There we go. Right down in this corner. Okay. Now it all snaps right up because it has clips right here on it, right there. And on the bottom, you can see these clips all the way around. And it has a ribbon wire here that has to be disconnected. This white part here, you can see here, can be pulled up. Like that. It just comes up quite easily. Just don't really force it too hard. Make sure it's up all the way across. There we go. There we go. Up all the way across. It's quite messy in here. So I'm going to grab the opportunity to use the air duster in here. I think that'll do. And now we need to get our new keyboard in there. This is a generic keyboard. It should work no problem. You can see it has the same clips around and the same style of ribbon wire. And this is the way it goes in. Now, the number one thing here, we have to connect it first. And it should go in relatively easily. Relatively. Sometimes these things can be very contrary. Now, is that in enough? We're going to find out. It appears to be in. How about we just boot it up from here without even clipping it in? We can do that just to test it. We'll boot it up. And you can see that there's an issue with the battery here. It needs to be replaced. This old system needs a little bit of work, including a new battery. And I'm going to press... Ooh, that's promising. I'll press the enter there, and it worked. I'm going to grab a mouse. Now this is going to log in automatically. I've got the password put in here in auto logon from here we go, from Windows. Kind of slow. This very slow and clunky operating system on 6 gigs of RAM. A little bit more RAM I think could be used in this. Let's see. Let's find Notepad.
Randy, do you recall which version of Windows is installed on the system?
This is 10.
Windows 10?
Windows 10. I managed to upgrade this old system's old 10-year-old system to Windows 10. And you see that? It appears that everything is working. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 characters here, no problem. How about the backspace? No problem. Q, W, E, R, T, Y, yeah. U, I, O, P. More characters, strange characters. Okay, A, B, A, S.
Randy, is the all caps working?
Let's have a peek at that now. I'm going to go down and do the rest of the letters here. Z, X, C, V, B, N, M. The rest of these characters are fine. And let's, the caps lock here. Let's click the enter here. Here you go. Q, yeah. Excellent. Now what we're going to do, simply do is shut it down and close it up and get the keyboard on there.
Okay.
Nope. Excellent. A working keyboard. Just shut it down. This mouse is a little contrary. Might have to investigate getting another mouse. There we go. Shutting down. Oh, that's jumping up because I had to set it earlier. Shut down anyway. Because we had no access to a keyboard, we had to use the on-screen keyboard. Okay. It can be slow to shut down. Come on.
Randy, you said this is an HP Pavilion...
15.
15.
Yeah, almost 10 years old. Now let's get the keyboard in. Now this is kind of tricky when it wants to be too. But we gotta find a place again where it wants to go in fairly easily. There we go. There we go. That spot there. There we go. The certain spots here always go in a little easier than others. This is pretty well good. There we go. I think we got this. Yeah. Yeah, that's in there. Ooh, wait a second. Okay. Okay, good. It's in. It's in all the way around. All right. Now let's boot it up again. Make sure we're still working. Okay. There we go. You can get past that. We need a new battery. Got a new battery in this one as well.
Okay. Randy, that'll probably be another video at a later time.
Yeah, another time. We probably upgrade RAM as well, okay, it's signing in, no problem. Man, this screen is really shiny. Okay, we'll have to turn off that on-screen keyboard. Although, I just remembered something. I gotta put that screw back in. Okay, we're back in business. Okay, notepad again, caps lock, yeah, turn off caps lock. Okay, we're fine. Let's close this. And we're going to shut it down again and put that screw back in, which I forgot. Okay. All right, waiting for that light to go out. It's kind of slow to shut down, but hey, it'll get there. Okay, now let's put that final touch here. We need to put the screw back in. This one screw holds that into place. Now we need that Phillips again. And there you go. Simple as that. It's done. It has a brand new keyboard. Now it needs a new battery. Only 6 gigabytes of RAM running Windows 10 on this old system. It could use a little more RAM as well. Now there we go. Okay. Okay. I keep forgetting to plug that back in. The mouse. There we go. And there it is. Okay, now. Yeah, okay, that we're fine. Caps lock. Yeah. Okay.
Perfect.
Perfect. Done.
Okay, awesome.
Excellent. Now we need to update this operating system here, and I can see the time needs to be set. But a new keyboard. Excellent.